All right, Shalom. First off and foremost, as always, I want to say Kol Halayim La Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Rakak Wadash. Double honors being to the elder apostles of Great Millstone that do rule and teach well. All right, Shalom to you, Ankim out there. It's pushing his truth through the spirit, through the power, and through the name of Yahweh Bashmal Shai. Okay, so this lesson, you know, it's basically going to be impromptu, open forum kind of a lesson, you know, but, I was just thinking, you know, like, we have all these prophecies, you know, beginning to come to pass, all right, in our lifetime, you know, and people, all right, still, you know, sleep, you know, people are still asleep, you know, and mainly, you know, Israel, okay, because this word, this gospel is meant for you, okay, but within the nation of Israel, this gospel is for the elect, you know, mainly, but also, you know, the elect, they're gonna come out of the world, man. You know, repent in the name of Yahweh Bashmal Shai. All right. So real quick, let me get the book of Second Address, chapter 15, and verse 1, and it says, "Behold, speak thou unto the heirs of my people." All right. Who is the Lord's people? The nation of Israel, because he chose him to be a nation near and dear unto himself. All right, Israel is the apple of the Lord's eye. Okay, and it says, "Speak thou unto the heirs of my people." All right, of my people, the words of prophecy. Right, man, the words of prophecy. Okay, and that's what the prophets, all right, the true prophets of Yahweh Bashmal Shai, are doing out there. Around in the name of Yahweh Bashmal Shai, okay? Because you got a lot of people, or like a lot of Israelites, you know, a lot of camps out here that they know that they're Israelites. You know, they may teach Jake, you know, certain things, you know, as far as Deuteronomy and to where fringes things like that. But they don't warn Jake, man. You know, they don't warn Jacob our prophecy. Okay, that's why, you know, certain men, you know, are going to be delivered, man. All right. And who is that? The elect. Because you know that you're an Israelite, you know, don't mean you're the truth. All right. Or just because you know that you're an Israelite don't mean you're a prophet. All right. And it says, "Behold, speak thou unto the heirs of my people the words of prophecy, which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord." Right, man. So we're a mouthpiece for Yahweh Bashmal Shai. All right. And a lot of Jakes, all right, are still in gross darkness, man. Okay, a lot of people out here are still in the dark because they, you know, they refuse to take heed and turn back to Yahweh Bashmal Shai. They refuse to, you know, to clean off, from the wicked ways. All right, they don't want to, you know, shit off that old man. All right, but that's why, like I said earlier, only, you know, certain the elect remnant is going to be delivered. Okay, because here it is, we have prophecy manifesting and hopping off the pages. Okay, people still can't see it. Okay, you know, you have things happening right now in the world that people don't even know about, man, as far as prophecy go. You have the third world brewing, which is World War III. All right, you have many events, you know, leading up to the third world, and that's in the scriptures. Okay, you have people getting chipped, and that is, you know, and that is the mark of the beast. Okay, people are, you know, having chipping parties. You know, people are getting chipped live on stage. You know, you have more civil unrest going on in places, man. More protests. So the Lord is moving things, man. All right. So it's evident that we're living in the last days of the last days. Okay. This is the book of Romans 13 and verse 11, and it says, "And that knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep." Right, man. The time, meaning right now, you know, in these last days, it's time to wake out of sleep. All right, to wake out of sleep, man. All right, and how do you wake up? All right, right quickly, I'll get it, because the Lord uses his men to get to Israel. All right, mainly the elect, of course. All right, but those men, Yahweh Bashmal Shai, all right, is waking up Jake, you know, from their spiritual sleep. All right, So this is Psalm 119 and verse 9. And verse 9 says, wherewith thou shall a young man cleanse his way? Right. How shall a young man cleanse his way? How is a young man, you know, in the world, a young Israelite man going to repent? How is a young man, a young Israelite man in the world going to, you know, come from his filthy ways? It says right here, it says, by taking heed thereto according to thy word. Right, man, by taking heed to the word of Yahweh Shema Shai. All right, once you take heed, you know, you know the names of Yahweh Shema Shai. So that further leads you to cleaving unto Yahweh Shema Shai. All right, and that leads to what? Repentance. Okay? That's how, you know, that's why it's time to wake out of sleep. All right? And it says, by taking heed thereto according to thy word. And going to the word heed, it means to observe. You know, so basically, you know, being a sponge and just soaking everything up, man. Okay, because now you want to get it while it's hot, because soon it's going to be a famine of the word, of hearing of the word of Yahweh Shema Shai. Okay, soon the prophets of Yahweh Shema Shai won't be in the highways and byways, and you know soon, or on YouTube. Okay, because you got Evil E, you know, being more crafty, you know, and pulling on, you know, putting out more policies on YouTube. So, you know, we gotta, you know, be wiser than ever during these times. You know, speak more and parable talk, you know, and just you know, move on, you know, and be wise, man. Okay. So back to where is it at? Shit, yo, Romans. Back to Romans 13 and verse 11, and it says, and now knowing the time, right, that now it is high time to wake out of sleep. Now, does that mean physical sleep? No, that means spiritual sleep. All right, being spiritually dead. Okay, because you got a lot of our people out here. You know, they may be walking. You know, they may be physically awake. You know, physically alive. But guess what? They're spiritually dead. They're not spiritually alive. That's why Apostle Gabar said our people are dead from the neck up. Okay. And it says, for now is our salvation nearer than when we believe. Right, man. So our salvation is nearer than when we believe, man. Okay. And Apostle Tahar deemed his year to be what? 2021, the year of hastening of the day of Yahweh Shema Shai. All right. And that's what you want to do, man. You want to, you know, serve Yahweh Shema Shai with all your ability, you know, to the best you can. Put your best foot forward. All right. And just, you know, continue to serve Yahweh Shema Shai, man, you know, as much as you can, man, because now it's time to wake out of sleep. All right. But guess what? If you don't do it right now, it's gonna be too damn late. Okay, you're gonna realize too late, and then before you know it, it's gonna be nukes in the sky, man. Nukes in the sky, just waiting to destroy Babylon. All right. So with that being said, I want to say, call Elohim La Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai Bahashem Rachak Wadash. All right, double honor being to the elder apostles of Great Millstone that do rule and teach well. All right, and shalom to you, Ankim, out there. Let's push in truth through the spirit, through the power, and through the name of Yahweh Shema Shai. All right, with that being said, shalom.